Now we are going to consider about the third quadrant operations of type E chopper. Now when we are considering the third quadrant, what is happening? That is the CH2, that means chopper 2, that is in on conditions, and CH3, the chopper 3, that is in operating conditions. So that means the CH2 is in on and CH3 is in operating conditions. So the source voltage is going to feed the load, but the polarity of the load EMF going to be reversed, because so that is going from this side, the current is going from this side. So the polarity of load EMF obviously going to reverse, and the current polarity also treated as negative. Now when the CH3 and CH2 is going to non-conducting mode, that means CH3 is going to non-conducting mode because we are considering third quadrant operations, that means after the conduction mode the CH3 is going to non-conducting mode. Now the CH2 is on, so that negative directional current that is going to freewheel through CH2 and D4, that is freewheeling through CH2 and D4, because CH3 is now non-operating condition, so that is freewheeling through this part. Now here the V0 and I0, both voltage and current polarity is treated as negative, that means the opposite to our conventions, so it is called as third quadrant operations. Now when we are going to considering fourth quadrant operations, then what will happen here? Only the CH4 is in operating conditions and other is in off state. So CH4, that is in operating conditions, so what will happen now? Obviously this source voltage cannot directly feed the load, but here is a EMF source, so the current is flowing through this part, that is flowing through this part. And when CH4 is going to non-operating mode, that means that is going to non-conducting mode, then what will happen? The current cannot flow through this point, but the stored energy in the inductor, that is going to discharge through this part, the D3 and D2. That means what happens? Firstly, CH4 is in conducting mode, then what will happen from this source EMF, this voltage source, a current is flowing through this circuit. Now when the inductor is going to store some energy, now when that CH4 going to non-conducting mode, so this energy going to dissipate and current is flowing through D2, L, D3 to the source. That means the current is going to feed the source from the load side. That means it is like a type 2 chopper. But here what will happen? See, for the conducting and non-conducting state of CH4, the current directions is in positive. But here the source voltage actually fed from the load voltage. So we are considering it as a fourth quadrant operation, where the voltage is reverse polarity, but current, that is in positive directions. Now if we are going to summarize the total of four quadrant operations, the type E chopper, then that is the graph for the first quadrant operations of type E chopper. CH1, that is in operating mode, and CH4 is in on state. When CH1 going to off, CH4 and D2 conducts. That means that CH4 and D2 conducts. For the second mode, that is CH2, that is only in the operated mode. Now the inductor stores the energy. When CH2 off, the storing energy is going to dissipate it from this side to the source, from the load to the source. In the third quadrant, CH3, that means chopper 3 and chopper 2, both are on. Chopper 3 is in operating mode. Then when chopper 3 is going to off, CH2 and D4 in conducting mode. That means CH2 and D4 in conducting mode. The current is freewheeling through this part. And in the fourth quadrant, the CH4 and D2, that is working. CH4 is in operating mode. When CH4 going to off, the stored energy going to dissipate it from load side to source side through D3. So this is the total summarized operations of type E chopper, and for today's work we discuss